to you. Jesus brings life with his darkness. Jesus brings hope with his despair. And Jesus brings life with his death. But the first thing he has to do is give you life. Understand something. All of us here today were created by God. Every little boy and every little girl, there's a purpose and plan for your lives, and God wants to do something in your lives. But that goes for all of you adults who are here as well. And you may say, no, listen, I'm older now, I've lived my life, whatever's going to be is going to be. No, God has something more for you. But the only way you're going to know what that more is when you allow him into your life. It's just like when you get some new appliance. Guess what? If you really don't know how to work it, what do you have to do? You have to read the manual. You don't just try to figure it out, right? You read the manual. Well, listen, why not turn to God today and allow him to unfold the plan for your lives today? Because surely, surely, ask yourself, there has to be more to life than just what you're living right now. Well, I want to say to you today, the same way Jesus was passing by and saw and took note of that lady, Jesus is passing by today and he's taking note of your situation today. And he's not asking you to join Trinity Christian Center. He's not asking you to give any money. He's not asking you to do 10 laps around Elizabeth, New Jersey. All he's simply asking you today is believe that I am the resurrection and the life. And whoever believes in me will not perish, but have eternal life. So today I ask you, and maybe you're here today and you're a believer. You've already given your heart to Jesus Christ. I say praise the Lord. But do you still find yourself in a place of darkness? Do you feel like, you know what, I'm in a place of despair? The good news is this, God has come to help his people. And the Lord is here today, and he wants to help you. You know how you get Jesus' attention? Simple. Just believe. Don't go by what so much, don't say that's good for so-and-so, and that's good for him, and that's good for her. No, it's simply, look, Jesus, you did it for them, then you know what, do it for me. What you did for Jay, he was in the hospital, they thought he was going to die, but you spoke life, and now he is testifying, singing in the choir. God, do it for me. What you did for Valerie and her husband, it seemed like it was over, and you brought the family together. God, do it for me. And I assure you on the authority of God's word that when you believe, you shall receive. I know we're outdoors, and it may seem strange to do something like this, but I want to obey God here, and I want to ask everyone here, if you would just close your eyes and bow your heads with me, please. Close your eyes and bow your heads. Every head bowed, every eye closed. I don't know where you're at today. I don't know what you're going through, but I know someone who wants to see you through. I don't know what place of darkness you find yourself in, but I know the light of the world, and his name is Jesus. I don't know where you find yourself being feeling hopeless. I'm telling you, Jesus is hope. He's all you need. And today, whatever you believe is dead, Jesus can bring it to life. But who he wants to first bring life to is you. Because when he speaks to you, and you draw close to him, then you'll begin to walk in the light, even as he is in the light. So if you're here today and you'd say, you know what, Pastor? I'm in that place of darkness. Everything around me seems bleak. I'm in a place of despair. I need light, and I need hope today, and I need life. Please remember me in your closing prayer. If that's you, just lift up your hands, and I want to just pray for you. That's right, lift it high. Don't be ashamed. Lift it high. If you would just do me a favor, everyone who lift your hands, just stand right where you are. Just stand. Just stand. Don't be ashamed. You just stand. Just stand. Just stand. Is there anyone else? No one's looked around. This is not a show. These are people who are saying, you know what? I need light in my dark place. You know what? I believe there are more people here. I believe there are more people here. Is there anyone else who would say, Minister, before you close in prayer, will you remember me? Just lift up your hands. I just stand right where you are. Father, I thank you for those who are standing here today, God. And Lord, my prayer, Lord, is that you would just be with them, that you would watch over them, that you would keep them. God, you see them in their dark place, but God, I thank you that you sent your son Jesus into the world to be a light for them, God. And Lord, as they draw close to you, as they say yes to your will for their lives, God, I thank you, Lord, that you will light their path, oh God. I thank you, Lord, you will begin to unfold your plan for their lives, Lord. I thank you, Lord, they no longer have to walk in darkness, but Lord, they can walk with you, and you are the light of the world. That means everywhere they step, you step with them, Lord. You will light their path, Lord. You will watch over them, Lord, from tripping and from falling and from hurting themselves, oh God. God, when they're looking for a way to escape, you will show them the way to escape, Lord. So today, Lord, I thank you, Lord, for those who are standing. I thank you even for those who may be sitting or who may be afraid to stand. God, I pray, help them to know, Lord, as they believe in their hearts, Lord, you would do it for them as well. And God, help them to know, Lord, that there is no despair for those who are in Christ Jesus. Because, Lord, you are with us, Lord. And if you are with us, who can be against us, Lord? If you are with us, Lord, what is it that we have need of that you won't provide for us, oh God? So, Lord, I pray that today, Lord, those who are not walking with you would say yes to you, Lord, and that they would walk with you all the days of their lives, Lord, because you promised you would never leave them nor forsake them. So, therefore, you will walk with them all the days of their lives, oh God. Today, God, if there's anyone here, Lord, along with those who are standing, Lord, who they understand that spiritually speaking, Lord, they're dead, Lord, because there's no life with God, because they're doing their own thing, acting their own way. God, I pray that today, oh God, they will say yes to your plan of life, God. Not just life here on earth, but life eternal, oh God. Because one day, Lord, we all die and we all must come face to face with you and stand before the judgment seat. But God, I thank you for those who are in Christ Jesus. We have nothing to fear, oh God, because all that awaits us is eternal life with you. And so, God, today, I pray, God, be with them, strengthen them, equip them, Lord. God, even as we put a Bible in their hands and some material to read, God, I pray, help them on this journey, Lord. Let them know that they're not alone, God, but that, Lord, you will be there with them. And so, Father, today, Lord, we commit them to you. We commit them to your care. We commit them to your keeping, Lord. And we thank you in advance for what you will do. In Jesus' name. And everyone said, and everyone said, amen. Come on, everyone stand with me. Let's all stand together. How many know that song, Amazing Grace? How sweet the sound. We're going to sing that as a closing finale with the choir. Now, here's the big joke. I can't sing. Okay? So I'm not even going to try. But we're going to sing together. All right? And those of you who stood, or those of you who were just afraid to stand, I'm going to be over here, and I have some workers with me that have some Bibles and some things we want to just give you. I want to let you know that tomorrow here at the church, we have a guest singer, Bernadette Harrell, who's debuting her new album. Service starts at 11 o'clock. All are welcome. There's no dress code. Just come as you are. We look forward to seeing you. You can make it. I'm going to come back after we sing this, and we're going to do the iPod raffle. But I'm going to ask everyone, come on, can we close our eyes together, and let's sing together Amazing Grace, everyone? seated. Let's finish off these raffles, huh? The choir is going to just do one last song as we dismiss in prayer once the raffles are done. Let me get this basket here. And I lost my Vanna White. Vanna Black.
All right, here we go. Now, we're raffling off now 4 book bags, okay? All right, we're going to do this quickly. 188935. 188935. 1-8-8-9-3-5. Oh, right here. Okay, let's give her book bag. Come on, let's clap when they come for these bags. Okay, 188-988. 188-988. 188. You gotta stay here. Yeah, that's me. Jump, shout, something. Okay. 2 more book bags. 188-650. 188-650. 188-650. 188-395. 188-395. That's you? All right. Got a book bag here. Sold to the gentleman with the fireman's hat on. 188-974. 188-974. Woo! I heard somebody screaming. Okay. All right. Now this is for... Oh, that wasn't it? Oh, okay. All right. One more book. What do you have? What stick is the ass, sweetheart? All right. Come on. Let's give it up for the little kitten here. What number did you have? No. Was there a 974? No, there wasn't a 974. No. There you go. All right. Okay. 6 iPods. All right. Everyone say, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Bless me, Lord. Here's my despair. I need that iPod, right? Okay. Here we go. Ready? 188-144. 6. All right, the whole row. You might want to sit over there. I don't know. There's something going on over there. Oh, I'm sorry. Take it up. 188-873. No. Wait, I just want you to know, it's not being said in the same order. It's like a hundred numbers apart. I'm telling you, better get over there. Honey, go stand over there. All right, here we go. I keep doing your job. Okay. 188-398. Oh, okay. How many left? Two left. Okay. 188-371. 188-371. Yeah. Jesus. Something about that name. That's my pal. Okay, here we go. Last one. Now, did I ever tell you the story about Spanish is 1-8-8-9-8-5. Come on, let's give it up. you, yes? All right, listen, we have those flyers. We have people who are going to hand out those flyers to you. Please, if you're without a church home, we welcome you. God bless you in Jesus' name, okay? Quiet, let's sing one more song. You can stand with us as they sing this last finale. God bless you. Dios te bendiga.